This is Papa Virgin Alkaloid. Actually, on the basis of sources, which the Papa Virgin belongs to the opium alkaloids. Opium alkaloids, they also include the morphine and laudanosine. In the starting, I told you laudanosine, which contain the beta. One of the ring was not containing the beta hydrogen. So we applied the MDA method. Here, actually, on the sources, plant sources, we said opium alkaloids. But on the chemical basis, we started with the chemical composition. Then there are isoquinoline group and phenanthyl group. From the opium alkaloids, papaverin and ladanosine, they belong to the isoquinoline group. And the morphine was belonging to the phenanthyl group. So now actually, source is the opium alkaloid. But yes, chemical, depending upon the chemical classification, it is belonging to the isoquinoline group. So now, as we are doing, it is isoquinoline group. We can classify it isoquinoline group. This belongs to the isoquinoline group. Then papaverin. Now papaverin, its molecular composition is C20, H21, NO2. That is 20 carbons, 21 hydrogen, 1 nitrogen, and then 4 oxygens. Melting point is 147 Celsius or centigrade. Then this compound is optically inactive because this alkaloid do not contain the chiral center. Its structure was first established by the Goldschmidt in 1883 to 1808. I think it's four work is much work was is done on this one. Step by step. If one structure is expected, then again, do the different methods to elucidate the structure of that particular fraction, then synthesize that particular fraction to confirm that. Again, if different fractions are produced during the reaction, then again deduce the structure of another fraction. Also, again to confirm the structure of that after elucidation of structure, then finally synthesis, use the instrumental methods also. So in this way, much more time is required to elucidate the structure of any particular unknown alkaloid. So the first structure of this papaverin was established by the Goldschmidt in 1883 to 1888, that within the 5 years. Here different types of methods are used, but this is the good example of oxidative degradation. When oxidative means using different oxidizing agents, and different stages, different temperatures, different times, the oxidation is applied over the structure of unknown alkaloid. Then unknown alkaloid is subjected to react with the different oxidizing agents. And then different fragments or oxidized products which are obtained by the oxidation of unknown alkaloid, they are studied. One by one, by using the different reactions, then by synthesis of the different fragments, whatever the fragments they are obtained after oxidation, to confirm the structure of those fragments. Finally, those fragments are combined together to establish a structure. Once the structure is established, then to confirm the structure, we are using the synthesis. So here, different structures, different reactions were used for the determination of the structure of different alkaloids. Here, papaverin, mostly the only oxidative process was. Oxidative destruction or oxidative degradation was used for the detection of the structure of the papaverin. Here, for example, the first simple reaction was the reaction with the methyl iodide. When the papaverin was treated with the methyl iodide, we got the quaternary ammonium iodide. And finally, when it was treated with the silver hydroxide, then silver iodide was produced. So in this way, gravimetric analysis, it was calculated how many molecules of methyl iodide was used. Actually, 2 molecules of methyl iodide was used to react with the papaverin to form the quaternary ammonium iodide. This was suggesting that there are the one single nitrogen is there, and that nitrogen is tertiary in nature. The nitrogen is tertiary in nature. Again, Ziesel method. When Ziesel method was applied, we know Ziesel method is used to determine the methoxy group. That is treating with the hydroiodic acid. So Ziesel method is suggested that the four methoxy groups are there. Four methoxy groups are present in the unknown structure of papaverine. Diesel method. Then, when diesel method was applied, methoxy group was removed. When methoxy all actually means four methoxy groups were there. And the removal of methyl group is known as demethylation. So demethylated product, demethylated product, when it is demethylated, it was known as papaverilone, papaverolin, papaverolin actually is a compound which is obtained by the demethylation of papaverine. Papaverine when demethylated, we got the papaverolin. Papaverolin is a compound which we call it demethylated papaverine. So second name, in the exam you can be asked, what is the name of demethylated papaverine? Or it's in other words, when papaverine is demethylated, which compound is obtained? We say it is papaverolin. So now, after this, let me do this.
सर सबसे पहले इसका स्ट्रक्चर किसने बताया था? गोल्ड आपने क्या नाम बताया? कंप्लीट
गोल्ड शिमाइट. ये आप ना गोल्ड शिमाइट. सम पीपल से गोल्ड शिमिट, से गोल्ड शिमाइट. पर्टिकुलर इस पे अगर मैं लिख दूं, या आप गोल्ड वॉल्यूम टू है ना, आईएल फाइनर वॉल्यूम टू, ये उसमें से पढ़ लेना, सारी चीज मौजूद है. टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री वॉल्यूम टू बाय आईएल फाइनर. लास्ट टाइम आपको मैंने बताया था इसका. Again, I'm repeating, textbook of organic chemistry, volume 2 by I.L. Finar, F-A-F-I-N-A-R. That is known as Finar. Now, you see, if the oxidative process is carried out, then we can write here papaverine when it was treated with the cold potassium permanganate. Cold potassium permanganate, you see, it is mild oxidizing agent. When the papaverine was treated with the cold potassium permanganate, oxidation took place and this compound was formed. We said it is C20H21NO4, papaverine. When this was oxidized, then we got the papaverinol, papaverinol C, here say how is C19, the number of carbon was decreased, H17, and here it was either 17 or 19 and O4. This is a papaverinol. So this alcohol was obtained on treatment with the cold KMnO4, potassium permanganate. Again, when it was further warmed, that is when the same solution, when it is warmed, the oxidative power was increased. So this compound was further oxidized to convert into papaverildiene. Papaverildiene, that is ketone. That is C19. We say this comes here. CHOH, that alcohol. It was not alcohol papaverine, it's alcohol it was produced after oxidation. Then we have this compound. That is here C19, H19. Here also H19, and NO, it's ketone. NO4, and then the CHOH was converted into ketone. This is ketone, and this ketone is known as papaverildiene. Ketone. You see, when this compound was oxidized, although there is no hydroxy group, if the compound contains a hydroxy group, then what happens? If you treat with the acetylating agent, acetylation will take place. For example, if you deal with the acetic anhydride, then some of the acetyl group will be introduced. If one hydroxyl group, one acetyl group. If two, then two acetyl group. But when it was treated with the acetylic agent, no acetylation took place. It means there is no hydroxyl group. But when oxidation was carried out, secondly alcohol was obtained. As the alcohol was obtained, when this alcohol was further oxidized, ketone was obtained. And we know that when primary alcohol, when this is general question, when what happens when alcohols are oxidized, we say carbonyl groups are obtained. When primary alcohols are oxidized, we say aldehydes are obtained. When secondary alcohols are obtained, we say the ketones are obtained. So once when the papaven was oxidized in the cold camera floor, we got the secondary alcohol. And when this secondary alcohol or whatever the alcohol was obtained, further oxidized in the hot camera floor, then it was converted into ketone. This is the confirmation. This is the confirmation that our alcohol which is present, it is secondary alcohol. Because the secondary alcohols, they are produced by the oxidation of, ketones are obtained by this oxidation of secondary alcohol. Primary alcohols, they are converted into the aldehydes. Here we got the ketone. That is why we say this reaction suggests that our compound is containing the alcohol which is secondary alcohol. And when it was prolonged heating, prolonged oxidation. In the starting, I told you this is the oxidative processes were carried out. Prolonged heating with the potassium permanganate, that is strong acidic agent. So then what happens here? First the papaverinic acid was obtained. And then different fragments. Fragmentation take place, decomposition take place, fragmentation after fragmentation, different fragments were obtained. One you see, papaverinic acid is obtained. This is the last oxidative state. Then fragmentation take place, and in fragmentation which different compounds were obtained. Veratric acid, number one. Veratric acid, number two. Number two is beta-hemipyridic acid. Third one is pyridine 2,3,4 tricarboxylic acid. Pyridine 2,3,4 tricarboxylic acid. Now third product is 6,7 dimethoxy. This was it. This is 1,2,3,4. Fourth fragment was this one. Dimethoxy isoconioline. Isoconioline, one carboxylic acid. These are the four fragments which were obtained.
2,3,4 tricarboxylic acid, pyridine jo ko sir yo to unme quinic acid ji oxidation mein mile ho na sange
ha starting material sange papa
varin ne structure mein ji acha sir unme quinoline group milno papa varin mein
ha yo bada deta hai
पहले ऑक्सीडेशन करेंगे तो हमें जो है वो पापा वेरिनिक एसिड मिलेगा, उसकी फर्दर ऑक्सीडेशन करेंगे फिर ये फ्रेगमेंट्स मिलेंगे।
पहले कीटोन मिलेगा, पापा वेरल्डीन नहीं मिलेगा, पहले अल्कोहल होगा, उसके बाद पापा वेरिनिक एसिड। पापा वेरिनिक ऑक्सीडेशन करेंगे ना, पहले होगा अल्कोहल, सेकेंडरी अल्कोहल, उसके बाद होगा कीटोन, उसके बाद फर्दर जो होगा पापा वेरिनिक एसिड, फिर पापा वेरिनिक एसिड की डिग्रेडेशन होगी या फ्रेगमेंटेशन होगी, फ्रेगमेंटेशन हो गया डिग्रेडेशन, उसके बाद हम ये मिलेंगे, ये वेराट्रिक एसिड, बेटा हेमिपाइलिक एसिड, पायरिडिन 2-3-4 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड एंड फाइनल चौथा होगा ये 6-7-डायमिथोक्सी आइसोक्विनिल 1 कार्बोक्सिलिक। ये चार प्रोडक्ट, चार फ्रेगमेंट्स मिलते हैं हमें, ये टोटल चार फ्रेगमेंट्स हमें मिलते हैं जब ये करते हैं ना इसकी फ्रेगमेंटेशन तब। अब इसमें देखो, अब ये कौन से चार मिलते हैं, एक उसकी चारों की स्ट्रक्चर लिखता हूं। एक तो ये है वेराट्रिक एसिड जिसमें पायरिडिन मौजूद है, सॉरी ये वेराट्रिक एसिड जिसमें मिथॉक्सी ग्रुप है, ये कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड मिथॉक्सी, ये वेराट्रिक एसिड। वेराट्रिक एसिड के दूसरे नाम भी है, ये है एक्चुअली बेंजोइक एसिड। व्हिच बेंजोइक एसिड? 1-2-3-4 डाइमिथॉक्सी बेंजोइक एसिड कॉमनली नोन एज़ वेराट्रिक एसिड। और दूसरा मेटा हेमिपाइलिक एसिड, उसकी स्ट्रक्चर ये है, ये एक्चुअली डाइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, डाइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड यहाँ इसका मिथॉक्सी ग्रुप, ये हेमिपाइलिक एसिड है, मेटा हेमिपाइलिक एसिड। अब इसमें देखो ये विदाउट दिस वन, अगर विदाउट दिस मिथॉक्सी तो ये कहेंगे ये थैलिक एसिड, थैलिक कॉमनली थैलिक एसिड, लेकिन इसे नंबरिंग करेंगे तो क्या होगा 1-2-3-4-5-6 तो अदर नेम ऑफ दिस हेमी एंड मेटा हेमिपाइलिक एसिड विल बी 4-5-डायमिथॉक्सी थैलिक एसिड। ये दूसरा फ्रेगमेंट हो गया मेटा हेमिपाइलिक एसिड। तीसरा पायरिडिन 2-3-4 का ट्राइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, पायरिडिन ये होगा मेटा, ये तो तीसरा पायरिडिन, पायरिडिन 2-3-4 ये होगा पायरिडिन 1-2-3-4 ट्राइकार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। और चौथा और आखिरी होगा ये 1-2-3-4 और फोर्थ इज दी 6-7-डाइमिथॉक्सी आइसोक्विनोलिन 1 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, आइसोक्विनोलिन नाइट्रोजन 1-2-3-4-5-6-7-8 1 कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड at the 6th position and 7th position, it is their dimethoxy. So these are the 4 fragments which are obtained on the vigorous prolonged oxidation. So now we say overall structure of this, the papaverine is composed of these, we say combination of the, all these 3 structures, 4 structures. One is this one, another this one, another this one, these are the 4 structures. Now keep in your mind, when we have these structures actually in practice, we have to first, once these all fragments are obtained, then the detailed ways, you apply the again different methods for the determination of structure of each component, that is 4. Then we'll use the different synthesis, synthetic tools to confirm the structures of these structures which are, you say, we you have deduced from the methods. We have different methods normally we are using. But now instead of using the individually, then this will be very longer one. So now just you keep in your mind, these 4 structures are there. The actual structure of papaverine is composed of these 4 structures. Now we are coming to the next point. When you have these, we say, these 4 compounds, now just like veratric acid, then hemipyrenic acid, then pyridic acid, here 6-7 the isoquinoline 1 carboxylic acid, these, now depending upon this, just keep in mind these structures. Now we are coming to the next point. When we have a structure, these structures, because now board is very smaller, so we cannot write other reactions are here. First was the isolation of veratric acid. veratric acid. This was the veratric acid, that is methoxy group, ring, and here carboxylic acid. Now we say it's X. Here it means it's this compound. One of these structures that contains aromatic 1, 2, 3, 4 in comparison of the carboxylic acid. This is the carbon of the carboxylic acid. So now here, with respect to this, we say this position is 1, 2, 3, 4 in the meta and para, or 3 and 4. And the 3 and 4 positions, we have the methoxy group, here carboxylic acid. So now again, this carboxylic, two carboxylic acid are here. This contain the aromatic ring, benzene ring, which contain the methoxy group at the 3 and 4 position. Again here at the 6th and 7th positions, the isol quinolyl group, and at this carbon, that is carbon number 1, at the number carboxylic acid is present. So now two carboxylic acids are present. In isoquinoline, it is present at the 1 position, and with respect to these are the 6th and 7th position. So here at the 1 position, carboxylic acid and benzene, and then with respect to this, 2 methoxy group at the 3 and 4 position. So now the presence of these two groups also from these structure, we say this accounts for the isolation of two other fragments. There are 4 fragments. The total content of carbon present in the veratric acid, if you see veratric acid, how many carbons are there? 6 carbon, 7, 8, 9. Total number of carbon is 9. Here total number of carbon is, you see, 6 carbon, 7, 8, and 9, 10, 11, 12. Here 12 carbon. So total number 12 plus 9, how much it becomes? It becomes C21. Total number of carbon becomes 21. But actually, if you remember, the total content of the carbon in papaverine, it is C20. Here total number of carbon present in the papaverine, they were 20. But here it is increasing to the 21. Actually, what happens? Other reactions, the reaction in which we say there was no hydroxy group, but even then, when we carry out the reaction oxidation, the alcohol was produced. Which alcohol? Hydroxy group, secondary alcohol. And when further oxidation, we got the ketone. That was finally converted into carboxylic acid. Actually, the carboxylic acid conversion of carbon, the ketone into carboxylic acid is not easy. Aldehydes can be easily converted into carboxylic acid. But if the further, or we say drastic conditions are used, then fragmentation takes place. So that fragmentation was taking place. Now here the problem is, when the alcohol is produced, it means something was oxidized. When the hydroxyl was, the group was converted, ketone means ketone second. This was due to the presence of, these reactions suggest that there is CH2 group lying into the molecule. We don't know the position of the CH2 group, but anyhow, CH2 group is present in the papaverine, so that when you carry out the oxidation, the CH2 group is converted into secondary alcohol. And secondary alcohol, when oxidized, the ketone is produced. So this reaction, these are suggesting that the CH2 groups are there. 4 other fragments we use to say the 4 fragments are there plus CH2 group is there. Now the problem is, if you say this carbon number 1 in this case and this carbon number 1, if they are one and same, that is the carbon of the carboxylic acid, if they are same, then we say now the CH2 group is this group, which is present in both the cases. So if we just keeping in mind the structure of these compounds, if you write a series of reactions, for example, let me write here, and then you apply the reaction. Then what happens? We will have a compound. That is the idea of the compound. For example, we have now here compound. If we say papaverin, expected structure from the foregoing reaction. We say if you have this structure of papaverin, and which is now we know that it is. Now if it is expected structure papaverin, then if the papaverin is oxidized, then what happens? The papaverinol was obtained. So here again, here reaction, that CH2 group will be converted to the alcohol. Secondary alcohol is produced. It means now it is confirmed that the CH2 group is present in the molecule. Here, this will become papaverinol. This is the alcohol papaverinol. And when it is oxidized, that is hot, KMn4, the remaining structure remains same. Only here, just you write here, say all structures remain same. Here, just you put CH, CH2, CHOH. This is converted to ketone. Other reactions are same. Just to you see, save the space, just I'm writing all structure, whole structure will be same. Only the CHOH group, that is secondary alcohol, it is secondary alcohol. This is only converted into this ketone. This is papaveraldine. It is papaveraldine or ketone. And finally, when this is further oxidized, then what happens? We got the papaverinic acid. And papaverinic acid contains the dicarboxylic acid. So papaverinic acid, again, they will remain same. All compounds will remain same. Only this structure. That is the isoquinoline molecule. This will contain this group, two carboxylic acid group at this position. Here, remaining group as it is, ketonic group, this group is like this one. So now, it was suggested that yes, papaverin, we know the unoxidation with the cold KMn4. We got the secondary alcohol. Yes, it is secondary alcohol is obtained. Also, when further oxidation was carried out, we got the ketonic group. Once ketonic, that is papaverin was obtained, then it was further oxidized and it was converted into So here again, whatever the reaction we have used, if you apply on the structure of this structure of papaverin, we have this finally papaverinic acid. When papaverinic acid was further degraded, then the four fragments are obtained. That was valproic acid, metahemipionic acid, pyridine, 1, 2, 3, 4 carboxylic acid, and finally there was 7,6 dimethoxy isoquinoline. And this was the suggested structure on the basis of oxidative processes we carried out. And this was confirmed. This structure was confirmed by the synthesis. This structure, final, whatever the structure we have proposed, this structure. This was confirmed by the synthesis. So here actually two syntheses are available. One synthesis was given in the 1909 and another, I think, 1945. That was the more simple and the yield was also good. So let me write here. That reaction was first in 1909 by the Pictet and Gems. And second, it was given by the Boyd and Wilkinson and Sons. And co-workers in 1905. That reaction, the latest reaction, is more easy and simpler. So now I am taking the book and I am writing the reaction.
Sir? Yes, yes. So, you said earlier, sir, retrosynthesis was done. What did you say?
Yes, sir. Give me a book. याद करने की जरूरत नहीं क्योंकि ये बुक पड़ा हुआ है. एक मिनट, एक बुक, एक मिनट. हाँ आप बताओ क्या करे
हो. ये जो उन्होंने मालूम किया इसका स्ट्रक्चर उन्होंने किस तरह मालूम किया है, मतलब पहले उन्होंने अपने पेपर वर्क किया, ये अपना पेपर वेरिन का, अपर वेरिन का, पहले उन्होंने रेट्रोसिंथेसिस अप्रोच की, रेट्रोसिंथेसिस फिर उसके जरिए पूरा कंपाउंड सिंथेसाइज किया, उसके जरिए उन्होंने स्ट्रक्चर मालूम किया है।
जी 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 हाँ।
अच्छा
तो अब क्या हुआ जो फिलामेंट बने थे, फिलामेंट
जी जी
वन टू डाई मिथोक्सी बेंजीन और इट इज आल्सो नोन ऑर्थो मिथोक्सी एनिसोर, द डिफरेंट नेम्स आर देयर फॉर दिस कंपाउंड डाई मिथोक्सी बेंजीन और मिथोक्सी बेंजीन आल्सो नोन एनिसोर फ्रॉम हियर दिस वन मिथाइल and this will be the group ether, which is ether methyl, then 2-methoxyphenyl ether. When they are treated with the formaldehyde and hydrochloric acid, whenever formaldehyde and hydrochloric acid, the CH2Cl group is introduced. So these are the ortho para directing groups, methoxy group. That is why with respect to this one, 1-2 this ortho para meta and para. So here one group is introduced, methyl. Here, this compound CH2, and this is known as, now this is known as without this benzyl chloride. Benzyl chloride, 1-2-3-4 dimethoxy benzyl chloride, or benzyl chloride. We can also call it, if you say no, this is anisole. Then which is anisole? Then we start from here 1-2-3-4. We said 2-methoxy here, 3 with 4 chloromethyl phenyl anisole. We say no, it's ether. Which ether? Then methyl and this one another group. Methyl, comma, here 2-methoxy, 4 chloromethyl phenyl ether. So these are different names for this compound. Once this compound is obtained, then it's treated with the potassium cyanide. In potassium cyanide, the nucleophilic substitution will take place. Potassium cyanide, potassium positive, and here chlorine is. Chhatma, who is that? Is it? Is that calculated? Is that clear? Is that? The chlorine group is replaced by the cyano group. Remaining everything same. Here we will get the cyano group will replace the chlorine group. So what is that? Okay, 5 minutes. Here, guru karaga. Here. Cyano group, chloro group will be replaced by the cyano group. Remaining reaction is same. Now, when it is this compound is treated with the two, that is when you first hydrochloric acid, then followed by PCl5. PCl5 is phosphorus pentachloride. What is the function of this phosphorus pentachloride? Again, this will is a series of nucleophilic substitution. So here again, the when you use HCl plus PCl5, then CH2 formyl chloride group will be introduced. Here other groups remain same. Here cyano group, the cyano group will be removed. This will be converted to CH2COCl. CH2 remains same. CH2 and CN group converted into CL. When you treat with the hydrochloric acid plus PCl5. But if you treat with the rainy nickel, and what is the function of rainy nickel? That is reducing agent. So hydrogen plus rainy nickel. Rainy nickel and normal nickel, the difference is the rainy nickel has more surface. It becomes more effective reducing agent. So when we know cyanides, they are the hydrolyzed, they are converted to carboxylic acid. If they are reduced, then they are converted into amines. So now if you carry out reduction, methoxy group, that is methoxy group, here CH2, here CH2 and H2. This compound is obtained. So this will be known as, this is common name of this compound is homo veratroyl chloride. Homo veratroyl chloride. Troyl chloride. And this is known as, this is homo veratroyl amine. Homo veratroyl amine. These are the common names. Otherwise, there are different names are possible. We say this compound is also known as here 1,2,3,4. 4, 2 methyl, 2 aminoethyl, here 1,2 dimethoxybenzene. If you know any sol, then this will be 2 methoxy and 4 will be the aminoethyl, then any sol. If you know ether, then methyl, comma, 2 methoxy, 4 aminoethyl is a phenyl ether. The different names are possible. But commonly, simplify, this is homo-veratroyl chloride and this homo-veratroyl amine. Now, once these compounds are obtained, now again, let me write one of the reactions. Do you know, if the acetyl chloride will react with the methyl amine, acetyl chloride, when treated with the methyl amine, any
guess how come? Acetylation of amine.
Yes. So now, actually, what happened? Cl will react with the H. Here?
Yes, sir.
Cl plus methylamine. H here. H will be removed. So now we'll get CH3CO here NH. This compound is formed. HCl will be removed. So now what happens? Here same reaction will take place. Here, veratroylamine and it will get right here. It's more simplified. Same compound. This compound amine is treated with the chloride. That is in this way. Here I am just writing this side on this side. Where here methoxy group, and from this side CH2. Yeah. So now here what happens? Cl from here, H from here will be removed. HCl will be removed and now we'll get here this compound. That is same methoxy group, here methoxy group, here methoxy at this position. Now here CH2, then CH, another CH2. Then after CH2, then there is NH.
Sir, आपने acylating agent पे भी दो methoxy group.
कहाँ पे?
Sir, जिसके साथ acyl group attached है, उसमें भी दो methoxy group attached है.
दोनों में नहीं, इसमें methyl methoxy इसमें दोनों methyl very trial amine उसमें methoxy group है, इसमें भी दोनों methyl group है.
Yes sir, ठीक है.
बाकी सही? ठीक है. बाकी वैसा का वैसा मैंने कुछ नहीं किया. ये CH2 CA2 इसका रिएक्शन सिर्फ होगा यहाँ पे पोजिशन. ये Cl ऑफ दी कार्बोनाइल क्लोराइड और NH H ऑफ NH. बाकी वैसा का वैसा रहेगा. जो जो हमें दो कंपोनेंट मिले वो आपस में फिर रिएक्शन करेंगे. तो ये जो मैंने चीज लगी है लिखिए ये सेम सेम है यहाँ. और ये रिएक्शन अब होगा यहाँ थोड़ा लिखने में तरीके. मैंने यहाँ सीढ़ी लिखा है, अब इसके मैं नीचे लिखता हूँ ये कंपाउंड. तो इसके बाद जो आपस में रिएक्शन करेगा क्या बनेगा? ये बने जाकर यहाँ पर रिएक्शन होगा Cl. ठीक है, निकल जाएगा. तो यहाँ बनेगा.
साइड में से बोर्ड नजर नहीं आ रहा
कहाँ पे? अभी बोर्ड से गिर गया. देखो आप अब नजर आ रहा है?
यस सर.
अब देखो तो NH इसका हो गया CH, ये CO इसका हो गया CO. यहाँ करो CO, उसके बाद CH2, उसके बाद CH2 के बाद वही सारा methoxy group और methoxy group. रिएक्शन हो रहा है किस चीज में? ये Cl और NH. इसका Cl निकला है, इसका H निकला है, इसका Cl निकला है. बाकी वही वैसा का वैसा कंपाउंड जैसे हमने पहले लिखा उसी तरह है. यही चीज हमने इस तरह. अगर यहाँ पे लिखो Cl, यहाँ पे लिखो H, तो HCl रिमूव हो जाएगा. बाकी हमें मिलेगा ये कंपाउंड. अब इसका भी नाम हो सकता है. इसका नाम आप कोशिश करें, आप अपने तरफ इसका नाम देने की कोशिश करें, वरना मैं बताऊंगा आपको. सिंप्लीफाई करें इसको. या तो इसको ले पेरेंट कंपाउंड, बाय ये होगा पेरेंट. या इसको ले आप वो अपना पेरेंट कंपाउंड, बाकी ब्रांच होगी. इसी हिसाब से नाम दें. उसके बाद क्या होगा, ये बना, इसके बाद डिहाइड्रेटिंग एजेंट P2O5, दैट इज फास्फोरस पेंटाक्साइड. व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द फास्फोरस पेंटाक्साइड? जस्ट टू रिमूव द वाटर, जस्ट टू रिमूव द वाटर. एंड इफ इट इज हीटेड, सो वाटर इट इज नॉट इजीली रिमूव फ्रॉम हियर. फर्स्ट द इनोल फॉर्म इज ऑब्टेन. फर्स्ट लेट मी राइट हियर, हियर CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2, CO, then CH2, here benzene or methyl CO. अब क्या होगा, ये इनोल फॉर्म बन जाएगा इस तरह. ओ हाइड्रोजन यहां से निकलेगा, OH, और ये डबल इलेक्ट्रॉन यहां आ जाएंगे, इनोल टाइप, इनोल. तो फास्फोरस पेंटाक्साइड पहले इस फॉर्म में आएगा, फिर इसको हीट करेंगे तो क्या होगा, वाटर मॉलिक्यूल, हाइड्रोजन फ्रॉम द बेंजीन रिंग, OH फ्रॉम हियर, दिस विल बी रिमूव, वन वाटर मॉलिक्यूल विल बी रिमूव. नाउ विल गेट द कंपाउंड, कुछ कंपाउंड ये होगा, इंटरमीडिएट इस तरह बनेगा, उसके बाद डिहाइड्रेशन होगी, तो हम उसके बाद जो कंपाउंड मिलेगा वो आगे बाकी हर चीज सेम. हियर CH2 लिखो या इस तरह लिखो, एक ही बात है. एन डबल बॉन्ड, हियर C, यहां होगा CH2, बाकी वैसा का वैसा. ये मीथोक्सी ग्रुप, श्योर बाकी हमें ये प्रोडक्ट. So now we will have this compound, and when this compound is treated with the palladium, asbestos, and 200 added palladium, asbestos, and heated at 200 degrees Celsius, then actually dehydrogenation take place. Dehydrogenation, hydrogens from here they will be removed, and we'll get the double bond here. And this aromatic.
The temperature.
I will get the now papa will here. Now papa will get structure to do. Papa will direct. Papa. So this is the synthetic. That is synthetic tool. Once we are getting this compound, it means whatever the method we applied for the detection of determination of structure, they were confirmed. It was they were correct.
Sir, हमने temperature कितना दिया?
200 degree centigrade. 200 degree centigrade. Palladium, asbestos होता है ना जो material, उसपे palladium रखते हैं, फिर ये compound उसके साथ heat करते हैं 200 degree centigrade में. तो dehydrogenation होती है, और dehydrogenation के बाद क्या होता है, ये कम ring जो है ये वाली ये aromatize होगी, तो हमें जो aromatic ring मिलेगी, बाकी ये compound मिलेगा. फिर पापा वेरिन, अब उस structure लिख लो, हमने पहले पता है ये structure ये. So now the structure of papa wheel will be confirmed. It means whatever the synthetic, the different reaction we have used for the determination of structure, they were correct. So actual structure of papa wheel is this one. Now it is confirmed. Now it is all about papa wheel. So हम जो कल करेंगे इंशाल्लाह वो करेंगे मार्फिन का. तो मार्फिन का थोड़ा पहले मार्फिन डिटरमिनेशन करेंगे, सेंसेस करेंगे, बाद में उसका एसीआर. इसका क्योंकि ड्रग कम ही इस्तेमाल होता है, कभी एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव इस्तेमाल करते हैं, लेकिन आज इतना इस्तेमाल नहीं है, उसके यूज ज्यादा है उसके मॉर्फिन के. तो थोड़ा डिटेल में एसीआर उसकी करेंगे, उसकी मॉर्फिन की.